An interesting information has appeared about the Navalny case. His people, opposition, dumped on the net the pictures of the bottles with Novichok, ostensibly with Novichok. The bottles were discovered by a mysterious Navalny's employee in his hotel room, 1 hour and a half after the announcement of his poisoning, that he felt bad, and FBK employees checked the room in gloves, how they got inside, where they took the key. This raises many questions. Firstly, the main question. There are three bottles. I think everyone was drunk from. Why, as we are told from sources, no official announcement. Novichok is found only on one bottle. Who drank from others? But why other people who were with him? It's clear there were other people inside. Or he drank only on this bottle. The bottle marked with the cross with Novichok. Why no other people poisoning? A lot of questions. The matter gets confused by a swift way. A publisher project publishes data. German doctors have not found Novichok in Navalny's body, but it was found only on the bottle. So many oddities, so many questions, they don't want to answer them. Just a nightmare. To begin with, answer these questions, then impose sanctions. We hear poisoning, poisoning, poisoning. Special services of Russia, sanctions, sanctions. And Novichok. The girl who gave the bottle, surname Pevchik, a citizen of UK and Russia, employee of FBK, disappeared. One version, he took the bottle with her. In Navalny's things, which were inspected in the airport, no bottles. She says she took them out. One or three. There is water in them. She took them out with her or in luggage. How she was allowed in with water? Many questions. We want to know answers. We want to know what happened. But before the answers, maybe he was poisoned. We have to find this person and imprison. It's a criminal crime. But sanctions are being imposed now. The heads of foreign countries are blaming us now. And ubiquitous, known to us, the head of the UK foreign ministry. Let's hear him. With Mike, we discussed the poisoning of Alexei Navalny. It causes severe anxiety. We are glad that he is getting better. In UK, we saw the result of using Novichok, when Russian intelligence used it in Salisbury in 2018. Using chemical weapons violates chemical weapons convention. There must be a responsibility, and we'll work on this with all our allies. The Russian government must explain what happened with Mr. Navalny for a full transparent investigation. It is difficult to find an alternative explanation of what had happened. We think it was an operation of Russian special services. The Russian government must explain. Russian special services operation. I get the feeling that the scenario of this investigation of the year is being written on the go. Like in a Russian cartoon, child Fyodor and cat wrote to his mother a letter. Everybody adds some writing. It's clear they have verdict. We are to blame. Sanctions will be imposed, pressure will be stronger, and as the Western people have short memory, they don't remember what was yesterday. They can't be fed with any nonsense, as about a hero woman with a bottle with Novichok in her luggage risked her life, life of passengers. I'm sure we will know who brought this bottle. We will know what had happened. As Narishkin told to us, Navalny left Russia without any poisoning in his body. Where Novichok appeared, we will know. And what happened in Russia, we will definitely know. with camps, limited access to the hotel, we will know everything. But we want an answer. Europe don't need our truth. This is the main problem. With the politics, everything is clear. It's clear, we are to blame. We are to blame if it is politics. But what happened in reality here? Nobody wants to answer our questions. Simple questions. Our representation in the EU asked EU. Our general prosecutor's office asked. Our doctors asked. No answers. No, we haven't. We will not get the answers, because they will have to speak the truth. They can't speak the truth. They get out composing fables. Again, UK ministry speaks about how people perished in Salisbury. If you know, there can't be Novichok in this case, because nobody died. The plane landed in Omsk. And if this damsel take away the bottle to Germany, let us speak to her. Yes, of course. It isn't possible. She's a valuable agent. If Europe considers it poisoning, did they take testimony of her? They'll compose and say they have taken the testimony. But it can't be public. Let them tell this. Why the video with the bottle appeared 2 weeks after the announcement that it was poisoning by Novichok? They have to fill this emptiness. Let's hear, I think, the most strange phrase from the investigation of the publisher project. The 4th of September, German Der Spiegel said Novichok was found on the bottleneck from which Navalny drank. It was saved by his relatives and given to doctors in Berlin. Journalist called them the key evidence which allowed German chemists to determine poison. There are no Novichok in the body, but on the bottle there is. From the hotel, Navalny went to the airport having been poisoned. In the water there were no poison. Before, one of the Novichok's developers, Vladimir Uglev, said, if it entered the body orally, Navalny would convulse in a minute. Uglev thinks Navalny got a dose of 20% from mortal. Only his skin contacted the poison. When it happened, in the morning or in the evening? Navalny doesn't remember when he drank from this bottle, an FBK employee says. So there were no Novichok in his body, not in blood, not in urine, not on his skin. So it is very strange. But we are to blame. Now they will get any trash to attack Russia.